Today, stage fright is extremely common in theater, using different apparatuses in several shows. Probably the most well-known is Peter Pan, which uses a variety of different types of rigs in different theaters to allow Peter to fly. Stage fright in the 21st century is now extremely common, being a major aspect of several shows. However, especially now, a different show means a different type of stage fright. Even within one show, types of stage fright can differ.
Creating space between us till we separate hearts. Plug your faith, it gives me strength, strength to believe.
We're breaking free.
Stage fright has been a component of theater for over 2,000 years. As early as 428 BCE, stage fright was used in Greek drama. Stage fright was also used during the medieval era, referenced in stage notes as ascents and descents. As theater developed, the concept of the spectacle or illusion became more appealing, thus leading to a rise in the use of stage fright. In the 14th century, ascents and descents were often used, yet with quite low success rates. In the 19th century, rigs with multiple wires to support the flyer became more common. In the 21st century, as technology has advanced and special effects in movies have expanded, stage fright has become a staple in theater, being expected by the audience in most shows.
One of the main reasons why knowing how stage fright works is important is because if you not calculate everything perfectly, something terrible can occur. Let's take a look at a time when the physics didn't work as well as expected.
The flight in Spider-Man can be amazing, but not when the harness breaks and the actor falls 30 feet at 9.81 meters per second squared.
This man suffered multiple broken ribs, as well as significant internal bleeding. Clearly, stage fright is a very complex science, so it is vital to truly understand the technical aspect of stage fright, or else every show will be another Spider-Man.
Stage fright looks amazing, but it does take a lot to get there. We wanted to discover the physics of the many types of stage fright through examining multiple rigs and how they work. In Peter and the Starcatcher, in order to allow one of the actors to levitate, she sits on a piece of wood which is raised from the back and sits on a small fulcrum. As a result, she appears to raise from the ground in flight, because the platform is not visible to the audience. In order for Molly to really look like she is flying, she must be lifted at a 30-degree angle of flight. So, given her mass to be around 54.4 grams, the actor pushing on the platform behind her will have to do so with 60.6 newtons of force.
The example of flight in Peter and the Starcatcher is without question entertaining. However, anyone can create this effect with a seesaw. The stage flight that captivates audiences is done using pulleys, winches, and harnesses. In the most basic sense, actors are hoisted into the air using ropes and pulleys. Once in place, actors are suspended in the air with the rope's tension counteracting the force of gravity. The more complex the flight, the more complex the winch. Let's take a look. The first winch we'll look at is called the single winch. As this winch only requires a single wire and winch, and much less training by both actors and the crew, it is by far the most commonly used. Just like we previously discussed, the illusion of flight is created by the actor's steel wire creating enough tension to counteract the force of gravity that is trying to pull the actor down. In this example, we can clearly see that all of these actors are simply moving straight up into the air, as they are attached to the winch by their harnesses. In truth, the thing that is by far doing the most work in this example, and many others like it, is the cylindrical pulley inside of the winch. This pulley is winding up the rope that is connected to the actors and thereby pulling the actors up into the air. As F net equals MA, the tension in the wire in this example is around 560 newtons. Using conservation of energy as every actor starts at rest on the ground before being lifted, we can factor in kinetic energy, rotational energy, and work, and to find that in order for an actor to move around just 5 meters per second, the pulley must be spinning at the rate of 87.4 radians per second. Wow. This next winch is called the traveling bridge system. On the most basic level, this winch is still pretty much a single winch. The actor is hoisted into the air by single pulley and winch, and then stays levitated through the tension of the wire. However, this winch is set apart by the fact that it allows for sweeping horizontal flight, not just vertical. This system works by the winch being placed on a complex track that runs throughout the theater. These tracks are placed in a checkered manner so that a crew member can control both the horizontal and vertical directions of the actor, as they can control the pulley hoisting the flight into the air and the position of the winch on the tracks. This example of Mary Poppins is a great example of the traveling bridge system, as she is moving vertically and horizontally at the same time. In terms of physics, one of the main differences in this rig compared to a single winch is tension. As this system allows for suspension in the vertical and the horizontal, tension must be factored in both directions. If we were to say that Mary Poppins was moving forward in this example with the acceleration of 0.25 meters per second squared and upward at 0.5 meters per second squared, and she is moving 2 meters forward, using some sines and cosines and tangents, we are able to find the tension in both directions. In the vertical, there was 627 newtons of tension, while in the horizontal, there's only 30.4 newtons. So, despite the horizontal movement being so important to the system, the most important aspect of flight is still without question the suspension.
One of the most complicated types of winches is bosun's chair. With this type of flight, the actor flies up and forward simultaneously. The rig uses two stationary winches that are placed far away from one another with two wires that connect to the harness. The wires are pulled out and let in at different intervals to create the illusion of flight. With the altitude always staying the same, the delta x, heights, and two thetas change. We measure the time it takes for a person to move 3 meters at 0.6 meters per second forward. In order to create large arcs while flying, bosun's chair must be used. For example, Spider-Man soars across the room quickly with two different wires attached to his harness to allow him to fly in many directions. Let's take a look. Stage flight is not limited to these few types of winches. However, by knowing these general systems, we can more fully understand how someone without wings can fly.
I believe I can fly.